Here I've got a 4-bit ripple carry adder that I've wired up in Logisim. On the left hand side I've got my 4-bit inputs A and B. On the right hand side I have a 4-bit sum with an overflow. And I want to do some arithmetic on this. The first one I'm going to do is 7 plus 5. I know the answer is going to be 12, but let's verify that it's working. So 7 is 0, 1, 1, 1, and 5 is 0, 1, 0, 1. And the answer comes out to be 12, 1, 1, 0, 0 on the sum with no overflow. Now let's do 5 plus 8. Again, I know the answer is going to be 13, but 5 is 0, 1, 0, 1, and 8 is 1, 0, 0, 0, and the answer comes out to be 13, 1, 1, 0, 1, also with no overflow. Now let's do 10 plus 9. 10 is 1010, and 9 is 1001. Now the answer of 19 can't be represented using 4 bits, so we get the answer of 3 in the sum with an overflow, and that's correct. Finally, let's do 7 minus 3. Now this is an adder. This does not subtract, so I need to turn this subtraction into addition, and you'll recall that 7 minus 3 is the same thing as 7 plus negative 3. So I can subtract 3 from 7 by adding 7 and negative 3. To do the negative numbers, I just need to find the 2's complement of 3. And I'll leave it to you to figure out that it is 1101. Now I know the answer is going to be 4, so if we look over here in the sum, we see indeed that we've got a 4 there, 0100. There's an overflow. We don't care about that. What we care about is that the sum comes out to be 4. So this is, I think, the really interesting thing and cool thing about 2's complement arithmetic, is that my 4-bit adder doesn't know anything about 2's complement. I didn't design this to be a 2's complement adder. I just made it a straight 4-bit adder. It adds up unsigned numbers just like you'd expect, which we saw in the first three examples. But it also happens to work for 2's complement negative numbers. You just calculate the 2's complement for your negative numbers and put it in and then just add them together, and the answer comes out correct. I think that's pretty nifty.